You know, governments have these two really powerful and pretty controversial tools to try and shape their economies: price controls and tariffs. Now, they're almost always used with the best of intentions, but as we're about to see, they can lead to some, well, some very unexpected and complicated results. So that's the big question, right? Are these tools a helpful hand guiding the market, or do they just end up causing more problems than they solve? To figure that out, let's jump into a pretty common scenario. Okay, so let's imagine a government is looking at the price of something essential, you know, like bread or maybe fuel, and they decide, wow, that's just too high. The average person can't afford that. So what's their first move? Well, before anyone steps in, a free market usually finds its own balance point. We call it equilibrium. Think of it as that perfect sweet spot where the amount of a product being sold exactly matches the number of people who want to buy it. But here's the trigger. The government looks at that natural equilibrium price and says, nope, that's not fair. Our citizens just can't afford that. Let's put a real number on it to make it clear. Let's say the market price for this thing settles naturally at 10 shekels. The government sees that number and they decide it's got to come down. So what do? They pull out a tool called a price ceiling, and it's pretty much exactly what it sounds like. It's a new law, a legally enforced maximum price that says you cannot sell this product for more than this amount, period. And bam, the government sets a new maximum price, 6 shekels, way below the market's 10. The intention here is obvious, right? Make it more affordable for everyone. But the reality, that's where things start to get really interesting. Because this is the moment where all those unintended consequences start to kick in. Instead of creating this perfect, affordable market, that price cap sets off a huge chain reaction. And here's the fundamental conflict it creates. At 6 shekels, consumers are thrilled. It's a bargain, so of course they want to buy way more of it. But think about the producers. For them, selling at that low price is way less profitable. So what do? They start making and selling less of it. And right there, you get this classic economic mismatch. There's a giant gap between what people want and what's actually available on the shelves. In simple terms, you get a shortage. And this is where human nature takes over. When something is scarce, someone, somewhere, will try to jump the line. You can just picture them whispering to the seller, "Hey, forget the legal price, I'll pay you 30 shekels, cash. Just tell everyone else it's sold out." And just like that, a black market is born, where the product is now being sold illegally for 3 times the original market price. So now, the government's attempt to fix one problem has created a whole new messy one. And their options to fix this shortage? Well, it means even more intervention. They might have to start importing the goods themselves or even build their own factories to produce it. And both of those are incredibly complicated and expensive. Okay, but price ceilings aren't the only tool in the box. Let's completely switch gears and look at another common intervention, but this time it has to do with international trade. Let's talk about tariffs. So in this scenario, let's say the government is worried about too many foreign goods coming into the country. Maybe they want to protect their own local producers from all that competition. The goal is simple: get people to buy less from abroad. And the tool for this job is a tariff. It's really just a special kind of tax that only applies to imported products. It's designed to do one thing: raise their price and make them look less appealing compared to the stuff made right at home. So how does this actually work? Well, think of it like this. Before the tariff, the price of an imported item is low and pretty stable. Then the government comes in and slaps a, say, 10 shekel tax on every single unit that crosses the border. And just like that, the base cost for anyone importing that item jumps up by exactly 10 shekels. And the effect is, well, it's pretty clear when you lay it out. Before the tariff, prices for consumers were low, and lots of goods were going imported. After the tariff, the price you pay goes up, the number of imports goes down, and hey, the government gets a new stream of tax money on whatever is still being imported. So whether we're talking about price ceilings or tariffs, you probably start to see a clear pattern emerging here, a pattern about the real cost of these kinds of economic interventions. And this is really the core takeaway from all this. The price ceiling was supposed to fix high prices, but it ended up creating shortages and black markets. The tariff was supposed to reduce imports, but it just made prices higher for everyone. It's a classic lesson in economics. There are no perfect solutions. There are only trade-offs. And that leaves us with a final, much tougher question to chew on. Knowing that these interventions almost always have these kinds of side effects, How do we decide when the original problem is so bad that those consequences are a price worth paying? That, right there, is the constant challenge of making economic policy.